All proteins look the same when they are laid out straight. However, if proteins are folded, the proteins can take a variety of forms and exhibit diverse functions. Here is an example of protein folding. You can see the peptide right here. This is a folded version of peptide. In this example, hydrophobic amino acids, or greasy amino acids, are shown in black. They tend to be inside of protein structure in the folded form. This is what I explained as a like-type interaction. Something similar tends to get together. So that's why you can see more hydrophobic amino acids inside the protein structure. So that was the like-type interaction. How about lab-type interactions? In the DNA structure, hydrogen bonding interactions were quite important to make base pairing. Using the concept of hydrogen bonding interactions, Dr. Linus Pauling from the California Institute of Technology was the first scientist to reveal the secrets of protein folding. In the spring of 1948, Dr. Pauling was a visiting professor at Oxford University in the UK. He had a bad cold and had to stay in his room all the time. After getting tired of reading detective stories and science fiction, he decided to work on a scientific problem he was interested in at the time. That was protein folding. The previous studies had given him an understanding of the precise structure of amino acids and short peptides consisting of two or more amino acids. He drew a short peptide with accurate angles and bond lengths on a piece of paper. Here is a piece of paper that is similar to what he used. You can find a PDF file of this in the course material. Please print it out if you have an access to printer. The peptide structure has NH and CO groups. Dr. Pauling played with the paper, folding it in many different ways to gain further insights into the structure of peptides. In the previous lecture, I explained the hydrogen bond. If you recall, I also explained that a hydrogen bond is the lab type of bonding. The NH and CO pair is one of the typical hydrogen bond pairs. I'll show you how to fold Dr. Pauling's piece of paper. As I mentioned before, CN bond right here has a partial double bond character. So these bonds are all in the same plane. These are on the same plane, if you recall. Then you cannot fold the paper between these atoms. Only place you can fold is on these. On these carbons. These are all called alpha carbons. So I'll show you a video I took this morning. Hold on a minute. Let me show you the video here. This video shows you how to fold the paper. Just try yourself. So then you gotta find the alpha carbons, they'll fold the paper on alpha carbons. If you fold them all, you're going to be able to find the helical structure. You'll see eventually you see CO NH hydrogen bonding here. CO NH hydrogen bonding here. Then you get the helical structure. So this structure is called alpha helix. In the alpha helix structure, every backbone NH and CO group of the amino, NH group and CO has a hydrogen bond. So that's why then they form the hydrogen bond interaction with the amino acid four residues ahead. This helical structure is quite stable and explains the structure stability of proteins found in our hair and hemoglobin. Dr. Pauling published the structure of alpha helix on February 28, 1951, which was his 50th birthday. Dr. Pauling's discovery tells us that the plenty of free time may give you an idea. Actually, this makes sense. When you work out a plan in a rush, you often conceive a conventional idea that anyone could think of. On the other hand, when you have plenty of time, an extraordinary idea may suddenly emerge. And when you run out of ideas, you rack your brain so hard that you might sometimes come up with an innovative idea. In the next video clip, I'll show you another hydrogen bonded structure that Dr. Pauling discovered shortly later.